Hello, this is Vern, and on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you when wanting love is actually hurting your chances of finding it. Hello, this is Vern. Welcome to your greatlifetobe.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can attract the kind of man you want and step into the most fulfilling relationship of your life as a result of stepping into the most alive and feminine version of yourself without the need to play games or manipulate men in any way. Now, I'm answering a question today, which is, when does wanting love hurt your chance? And I'm gonna be different from what you've heard before, perhaps, on this. I think that for most human beings who want love, in some ways, it's hurting their chances. And here's why I say that. After having had the blessing of having more conversations with single women than probably most human beings in the world will ever have as a result of my relationship coaching practice, I can tell you that most human beings, it's human psychology to equate wanting something with having the skill, the ability, the hunger, or the chances of getting it. Wanting love is essential. Craving, deep desire, connection, union, devotion. Like, that's the birthplace of finding love. But most people I have connected with who do that, leave it at that. So what does that mean? It means that it's not enough, but sometimes it's an intense feeling that because it's intense, you get a chance to feel like that's all you need. Well, I want love, therefore I should get it. I deserve it because I want it. And it's not true. If you want a passionate, fulfilling, meaningful relationship, you don't deserve it until you create it. You don't deserve it until you step into it that way, until you risk the way you need to risk, until you set the right boundaries. So the difference between the two groups of women I've connected with is the majority of women I've connected with, and I'm saying this with kindness, have wanted love. The minority of women I've connected with have been committed to getting love. And that small jump is all the difference. It's the difference between boiling water and steam. Maybe 1 or 2 degrees of saying, I don't just want love, I'm willing to do whatever it takes to create it. So I'm gonna share with you right now 3 specific commitments that you must have if you're not getting love and you wanna find it. Here's what it takes. First commitment is to dig deep, and sometimes it takes an outside perspective to understand what is not working. Because unless you understand what's not working and you attempt to solve this through just connecting with more guys, if there's something inside that's preventing you from setting the right boundaries, for example, or maybe that's making you attracted to the wrong type of guy, connecting with more guys is not gonna solve it. So the first commitment is, I'm going to figure out why the hell this hasn't worked for me in some time or forever. Second commitment is, you need to commit to change it from the ground up, meaning sustainably. So I'm committed to finding a solution. I'm committed to getting uncomfortable. I'm committed to shining more light. I'm committed to connecting with my sensuality in a different way. I'm committed to opening my heart. I'm committed to closing my heart when I need to. I mean, the commitments that you have to do to actually change it, that's where the work is at. And the third commitment, and it's by far the most difficult one, is the commitment to stay in the freaking game, not only when it's easy, because anyone can do that, but when it's hard. When you've been at it for maybe 9 months, 10 months, a year of doing it right, not even doing it wrong, doing it right, and it hasn't happened, that you know that you might be just one day away of getting it and staying in it for the long haul until you manifest it in your life. So there you have it. Commitment versus wanting. If you just want love, chances are you're not gonna get it. If you're committed to getting love, then you'll find a way. So commit to know what's not working, commit to change it, and commit to stay in the game until you get what you want. Hope this is helpful to you. If it is, I'm gonna ask you to do 3 things, my dear. Number 1, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number 2, subscribe to my channel. Number 3, on the first line on the description of this video, you're gonna find a link that will direct you to a free masterclass that I've recorded for you. All you do is enter your name and email when you're prompted, and then you'll start watching that 40-minute masterclass that's gonna share with you how to step into the kind of relationship that you've been wanting. If you want some additional handholding, some help in the process of finding love, then second link in the description will allow you to apply to work with me. Thank you so much for connecting, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.